All right, today we're going to take a quick look at Samsung's new high wall units for both the RAC and the FJM systems. The version you're looking at is our Quantum 2.0. The processes and procedures I'm going to show you would be very similar if we were working on the new Windfree 2.0. First, I want to show you some of the unique features, then we'll actually disassemble the unit to show you how easy it is to install and service. If you look at the front of the unit, we have our motorized louver that's going to open and swing. The louver is going to move in a different direction. On previous units, the louver moved from the bottom upward and then through the air downward. Our new models will now have the hinge from the bottom instead of the top. This will allow the unit to avoid blowing cold air directly on the occupants. Here's the full 7-segment display. This will show you the set temperature, kilowatt consumption, current unit status, and any error codes if present. The power button is located on the upper right-hand corner of the display. A simple push will turn the unit on and off. On the previous triangle models, the power button was located on the bottom of the unit and protruded out. With the button integrated on the display, the unit is more sleek and more streamlined. Let's take a look at what it would take to install the unit. What I'm going to do is turn the unit over and show you how easy it is to remove the backplate. Simply slide the backplate over, press these two tabs right here, and lift the backplate out. And what you'll notice is no screws were required to access the backplate. A new feature included in every single wall mount unit is this Molex plug. In a bag that's included with the unit, you'll find a female Molex plug with two wires connected to it. The two wires that would plug here could be used as an overflow to detection connection for an external float switch. Once the system is powered up, simply change an installer option to let the unit know that the overflow detection device is connected. If you're going to connect a wired controller, a sub-PCB will connect to this Molex plug. The sub-PCB will have an external contact connection with two wires off of it that can be used for the overflow detection or for your float switch. The filter sits on top of the unit and it's really simple to remove and reinstall. The filter itself is an electrostatic washable filter that allows the particulate matter to adhere to it. The new mesh is finer, smaller openings that greatly improve its ability to filter and clean the air. Once removed, the filter can be vacuumed and or washed quickly and easily. The return air sensor on our triangles units was located right here on the right-hand side of the evaporator coil. The new location for the return air sensor is on the lower right-hand side of the unit in the suction side of the air handler, so only return air will pass through the cavity for a more true return air temperature sensor reading. Now let's move on to installing the unit. In the past, to gain access to the electrical connections, condensate connections, and the refrigerant piping, you had to remove two or three screw covers and two or three screws, then gently pry the cover off the unit. Now the entire bottom assembly comes off without a single screw. One of the concerns people had about transitioning from triangle units to the rectangular units was losing the ability to access these items from the bottom without having to pry the unit from the wall for back access. If you look at how the new rectangular model is designed, you'll see that we have access to the condensate connections, refrigerant pipes, and electrical connections right at the bottom of the unit. So depending on the installation, the unit could be mounted on the wall and the connections can still be made from below the unit. There will be one or two screws that must be safely removed to gain access to the electrical connections, as this is a safety requirement. So what you'll notice is the only time you need to remove screws is to access the electrical connections and for any post-installation service work. Now this is a Quantum 2.0 unit, so you notice we have no micro holes on the face of the unit. If this were a Windfree 2.0, you would see micro holes across the louver and the entire front panel. After prolonged use, there is potential for dust to accumulate on the micro hole panel. So how would you clean the micro holes on the Windfree unit? Simply reach around to the left and the right, and you can remove the entire panel. Once the panel was removed, you could simply vacuum or wash the panel off fairly easily to remove the dust and debris. To service the unit, All you're going to need is a Phillips screwdriver. I'm going to remove a total of 2 screws, and perhaps a third if I need to change any major components. Looking at the bottom of the unit, you'll see 2 screws. I'm going to remove these. Now that I've removed these screws, I simply move the louver out of the way, pry each end of the panel loose, and remove the entire cover. Now that I have the entire cover removed, I have full access to the 7-segment display. Should I need to troubleshoot the display or the infrared receiver, I can simply push down on these 2 pins, remove the cover, and now I have the entire display board in my hand. If I need to replace the display board, there's simply 1 Molex connector to remove, which makes for an easy changeout. I can pull the louver assembly down and out to gain access to the blower wheel and the entire coil. So I have full access to the blower wheel and the coil. Looking at the coil, you'll see that it's a 1, 2, 3 slab design coil. So you're going to have better air temperature distribution because now you have a coil with more surface area. If I want to access the control board, there's a metal box right here on the right-hand side, and I simply remove the cover by lifting the tab on the top and taking the cover away. One of the challenges with traditional wall mounts unit is that they require a minimum of 4 to 5 inches of clearance on both the left and right-hand side. For anybody servicing a unit, if there were only 5 inches of clearance on the control box side, it can make squeezing your hand in here to use a meter very difficult. Samsung has made some enhancements to make the control PCB service assembly easier, which I'll show you in just a moment. Again, to make cleaning the blower wheel and condensate pan easier, the entire drain pan assembly will lift right out to provide unobstructed access. The only thing I will have to do is I'll have to remove a couple of wire connectors from the main control board, and then the entire drain pan assembly can be removed. Should the troubleshooting process lead me to further diagnose the control board, Samsung has created a unique feature to make this easier. There's one more screw located right here on the edge of the motor. Using a magnetic screwdriver, I can remove that screw and I may need to remove a couple wire harnesses to get the board loose and free, the louver assembly. And then I can simply push down on the control box and have the whole thing in my hand. If I come back and cut a couple of wire ties and remove the sensors, I can stand on top of the ladder with the control box assembly in my hand while I make my inspection. Not only does this make service easier, but if I have to replace the control board, I have plenty of room to do it. Another component that may need to be replaced that can be tricky is the blower motor. Now, Samsung's made it easier because there's a screw for the blower motor housing located here. Simply remove the screw then go to the control board and remove the wire harness for the blower motor and now all I need to do is lift up pry the motor housing free. And now all I need to do is reach down and I have the motor in my hand. Should I want to replace the motor, all I have to do is look for the set screw on the blower wheel that's holding the motor to the shaft. Remove that with a Phillips screwdriver. And I now have the entire blower wheel in my hand to replace in just a matter of minutes. To recap, Samsung's new Windfree and Quantum 2.0 high wall units are easier to install and service. They're more compact, and the improved design of the unit provides better airflow and can enhance occupant comfort. Thank you.